So I'm playing around with my 4017 stuff since I built that a few days ago and just having fun. But it occurred to me, these aren't the only 4017s I've got. I also have a whole pile of surface mount ones. Obviously, you can't breadboard those because they're a great deal smaller. But anyone who's been watching for a while may also remember I've got these SMD to dip adapters in a few different pinouts, including some 16 pins. And 16 pin happens to be what the 4017 is. So I'm going to just quickly solder that on, throw that into the breadboard, and play with that. Also going to need, I guess, some header pins. That's probably enough. I'm going to clamp it up in my vise here so I can get it up off the bench and not melt the bench, and also get it a little bit closer to my aging eyes. So, as always, a little bit of tinning on the soldering iron tip. Generally, with this surface mount, and I'm no expert on it, but generally, if you can do it with an iron, you just tin one corner, in this case pin 16. Get them all aligned. Flow that one down. Now that's mechanically anchored. Spin them around. I'm a little bit far this way, that way. Focus again. So I'm going to just melt that a little bit and slip it up and try not to burn my fingers or slide it all over the place. Is that a little bit better? I think so. Just do them all. Doesn't take much. I'm moving around because I want to spread the heat around. I don't want to kill anything with excess heat. A little bit of a blob of solder hanging on there, so I'll just give it a quick cleaning. That's better, and continue on. Now then, I'm told that there's different methods of doing this, and if you get excess solder on and create bridges like that, it's not a big hairy deal. So you just come back in with wick afterwards and clean it up. So looks like I'm gonna have to do that anyway. I'm getting uglier by the minute. So I'll do that, which apparently is a real thing called the drag method. I'll grab some wick. So there's soldering wick that I've had for a long time. I did buy some from China as well recently, but I'm just going to use this and get in there and pull the excess out, theoretically. Maybe it wants a bit of flux just to help it go better. Don't push too hard or it'll end up on the floor. Important safety tip. give her a quick cleaning with some flux. Actually, I've also got this paste flux, which I might just melt a bit into the wick. Okay, that's got some of it out. I've never done this before. This is all a brand new experiment for me, so, ow, that wick's hot. I don't usually use wick. I don't usually play with surface mount. Okay, that looks moderately. Ah! What a horror show! Let's just clean up the other side, which is equally horrific. I'll be surprised if this thing actually works at the end of this, but. This is how you learn. Trial by fire, trial by doing. That's better. Let me get right tight in there. I can smell the rubber burning of my of that. Okay. I'm going to, so I got a bit of solder into some of those pin header holes, but I'll deal with that later. I'm going to get a bit of alcohol and a swab and just clean that up. Yeah, that's a little bit better. Dry it off so it's not quite so shiny. There, no solder bridges left. They'll appear to be connected. Okay. Next step, header pins. Okay, so the header pins will snap off two strips of 8. She is right there and is that 8 there? That's 7, bugger. Okay, there's another 8 there. Okay, and just to keep the hole alignment and the pin spacing and parallelness all good, let's jam them into a random breadboard. And that's not going to work perfectly. Yeah. No, because there's two of them that I buggered up. One on this side here. So I guess that will be the first one that I solder. Bit of a clean there. There, that's down through there. Now this side, I've already sunk it down. It's pushed itself in, so where'd my bit of solder go? That's okay, I can cope with that. Let's get the two corners just to mechanically hold it. Okay. Now when I pull this one out, that one pin is not likely going to come out of the board. They're not likely going to come out of the breadboard, I should say. Oh, it did. But you see, there it got shoved down. So, I'm just going to heat it and press against there. And there it is. Now that the corners are in place and it's all held together, that should just solder up nicely. I don't have to worry about melting my wee breadboard. Not that that would be a huge hardship, but you know, you don't like to damage stuff if you don't have to. To find balance between if you're not breaking stuff, you're not learning, and wasting resources. Come on, behave. Always works better when you clean your tip. Okay, let's zoom in tight on that and see how those look. They look better if they're focused. A little bit blobby, but I can live with that. Okay. Time to throw it into this one and see what happens. Pin one that way. Okay, will it work? Push your bits. Ha ha! That's excellent. Just like its brother, only smaller. Oh yeah, you'll notice this one's going slower. One of the modifications that I talked about in the previous video was changing the speed of it by changing the capacitor, which I've done. I've just added a second capacitor in parallel, which is increase the capacitance because capacitors increase value in parallel and reduce in series, the exact opposite of how resistors do it. So now I've got this guy going a lot slower. Makes it easier to see. This one is built exactly as factory. That's the slowest it goes, that's the fastest. This one right now is with those with that selection of capacitors. That's the slowest it goes. And that's the fastest. I think I put in a 3.3 microfarad capacitor in parallel with the... No, 3.7 I guess it is. In parallel with the existing 1 microfarad capacitor. So for a total of 4.7 microfarads. So yeah, there's just a bit more playing around.